That's how durable it is.
Asshole.
What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel, and please excuse the mess behind me. Things have been happening. So for those of you wondering what's with all those sexy pre-roll ads popping up everywhere like Ebola, I'm finally able to tell you, because today marks the long-awaited launch of the Define R5 mid-tower chassis from Fractal Design, successor to the widely successful Define R4, which is actually the case I've been using for my personal rig, which, as you can see, isn't chilling in the back where it usually is. By now, there's undoubtedly a dozen reviews of this case that have just hit the web. In fact, you may have already seen a few of them. So to keep things fresh, I decided to switch things up a bit. Quite literally. Instead of doing a typical review, I'll be gutting my desktop PC and reinstalling everything into the Define R5. Here's me taking apart my Define R4 system now. So yeah, as you can see, I time-lapsed the whole process from start to finish, and along the way I'll be letting you guys know what about the Define R5 worked for me and what didn't. So I guess you could say this is sort of a first look, build vlog, review thing. Whatever it is, I'm keeping things pretty casual this time around. I'll also be talking about all the differences of this new case over its predecessor. Although since the entire build takes place inside of the case, let's start things off with a closer look at the exterior before working our way back to the time-lapse. So what's new here? Same Scandinavian design, identical dimensions. At first glance, there doesn't appear to be many differences, if not for the front door, which now sports a matte finish instead of the glossy reflective polish on the Define R4. The matte finish is a breath of fresh air in my opinion, and almost makes the door of the Define R4 look cheap in comparison. Another thing with the door, you now have the ability to choose which way it swings open, a huge bonus for people who keep their desktop anywhere. Left or right, whatever your preference, you'll be pleased to know the Define R5 swings both ways. The inside of the door is lined with sound dampening material made of a more rugged construction than the simple foam padding we saw on the Define R4. Although this seems like a pretty closed off case, you still get that side ventilation on both sides for healthy airflow. There's the same power LED that lights up blue when powered on, a 3-channel fan controller with 3 speeds, 2 5.25-inch bays, and a removable dust filter for quick and easy cleaning. Behind it is one of 2 pre-installed 140mm GP14 fans, which spin at 1000 RPM. There's also a crazy amount of fan and radiator support here. 120, 140, 240, 280, and 360mm configurations are possible at the front of the case alone. And this is one of the big renovations of the Define R5. Ridiculous amounts of custom water cooling support in a relatively small form factor. You get all of the same mounts at the top of the case, in addition to 420mm support. Here you can see they've also added 3 vent covers with sound dampening material underneath to aid in acoustics. To prioritize airflow, these can also be removed by pressing in a few plastic tabs from within the case. Front I/O includes mic and headphone, power and reset, and 2 pairs of USB 2 and USB 3 ports. Like the vent covers on the top of the case, there's also one on the left side panel that can be removed if you want to mount a 120 or 140mm fan. A nice addition to the side panel is a quick release latch at the back that allows for easy removal without the use of thumb screws, though they've included those as well for additional security. I should note that Fractal is also offering a side panel window version of this case, and any Define R5 can be shipped in either black, white, or titanium. Not much to see on the other side panel, though both of them are interlined with that new sound dampening stuff as well. On the back is a second 140mm GP14 fan, which has vertical adjustment for top radiator clearance, as well as mounting points for a 120. 7 expansion slots, and by now you can see Fractal's once again gone with a black and white color scheme. The feet of the case are still nice and shiny, but are now angled slightly inward, and are identical in size, as opposed to the larger front feet on the Define R4. I personally like the look of the old feet better, but then again, feet aren't something I'm really into anyway. A new and improved dust filter at the bottom now spans the entire length of the case for the power supply, and you guessed it, more radiators. The bottom can support a 120, 140, and a 240. And that pretty much wraps up the outer shell of the case. Overall, I'm digging it so far, but now let's jump back into the time-lapse and finish up this system swap. Alright, so I finished uninstalling all the components out of the Define R4, and now I'm moving on to the Define R5, which is what you're seeing right there. Comes with all the accessories you might need, screws and whatnot. It also comes with a little hex adapter to Phillips head for installing your standoffs, which is nice. It is plastic, so I was careful not to strip it, but it worked out just fine. There is a pre-installed standoff right in the middle of your motherboard tray, which helps mount the motherboard quite easily. It's always appreciated in cases. Went in no problem, screwing it down. and I think I'm gonna be popping out those three Moduvent covers at the top of the case. Yep, there they go. I'm installing an all-in-one CPU cooler in this case, so those need to go. At least the two on the back do. I'm gonna reinstall the third one later. The plastic tabs that you pop out to remove those covers, they're all within the case itself, although one of the tabs is on the opposite side and you can only access it when you remove the right side panel. So I thought it was kind of weird that I was able to pop, 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 and then I was like, oh, the last one is really hard to get to, which kind of slowed down the building process a bit, but I was actually able to get it from the left side with a screwdriver. I popped it out with my screwdriver because I'm smart. Get that thermal grease on there. And I did connect three of the case fans. Well, there's only two fans that come with the case, but I you'll see later I install an additional fan from the Definer 4, actually. I connected all those to the built-in fan controller on the case. It is a three-channel fan controller once again, and it is SATA powered. I forgot to mention that earlier. Power supply goes in just fine. There are rubber pads at the bottom to reduce noise and vibration. It can support 190 or 170 millimeter length power supplies, depending on if you have a 120 or 140 millimeter fan installed at the bottom. Without the fan installed, you can go all the way up to 300 millimeters. And you can see right here, you actually have three Velcro straps, which make the cable management process a lot easier. I really do appreciate that. It's a nice touch. Front panel connectors went in just fine. Grommets were well placed. There's even a little grommet to the left of the motherboard where like your HD audio cable would go, which was very nice. The rubber grommets on this case are a bit smaller than the Definer 4, but they work well. They're not so big to the point where they're distracting, and they're not too small to the point where they're tight. They are really close to the motherboard, the side of the motherboard, so it actually hides the cables very well. Here I'm installing the hard drives and SSDs, and there's a ridiculous amount of hard drive cage configurations here. You can see that there's two cages, one holding three and one holding six drives. Both support 2.5 or 3.5 inch drives, and you'll see I'm about to do some rearrangement here in a bit after I do some more cabling. Installing those stealth SSD drives, there are two stealth mounts at the back for 2.5 inch drives. I have three SSDs in this system, so two of them are going back here and one of them is going in the drive cage on the other side. But I really like this addition. Bear in mind though that this does reduce your amount of cable management space significantly, at least in that area. But there is a recessed part at the bottom of the case on that side with like at least an inch of space, so I had no problem fitting everything in there. I wish there were some more tie-down points though there at the very bottom of the case. That would have been nice. So you can see right there, I just removed the optical drive bay. You can actually remove it, put a drive cage up there, and I actually really like that because it opens up more airflow at the bottom. And there you can see I'm installing an additional fan, another 140, once again from the Fractal Design R4. And I really like how this configuration is looking right now. I think it looks better with the drive cage up there and the stupid optical drive bay is out of the way, and additional airflow to the video card is always nice. So strapping in some more cables, connecting the drives, using those sexy sleeved SATA data cables. Oh yeah. And again, cable management was fine. Didn't have too much problem. There goes the video card. Does support 310 millimeter video cards with the top hard drive cage installed. When it's removed, it can go all the way up to 440 millimeters. So you shouldn't have too much problem there either. Decided to route that PCI Express cable just around the side of the motherboard tray. It actually looks better routing around there than one of the rubber grommets. It's probably also because I have a massive video card. No real easy way to get around it. Side panel went on just fine. Boom, boom, boom. Replace that one Moduvent cover. Do some final cabling, some zip tying, and voila. All right, so there you guys have it. All I have to do now is put it where my old desktop used to be and weird. Even though the Define R5 has a few quirks here and there, it's still a great improvement over the R4 and delivers just about the best water cooling support for a chassis of its size. So I'm giving it a thumbs up. And you can give me a thumbs up too if you found this video helpful by hitting that like button. As always guys, don't forget to bookmark my Amazon affiliate link and use it every time you buy computer cases. You can also make a monthly contribution on Patreon to help the Awesome Sauce cause. I'm Kyle with Awesome Sauce Network. Thank you guys for watching. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, and I'll see you in the next video. We'll be right back.